the UK, and I see the same level of energy and passion for important issues among those people as I see here. So thank you very much for the invitation.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yes.
Yes, Mr. Randall.
Okay. Hi, I'm Magdalena. I work for the Ministry of Regional Theater for International. And as some of you might know, Prague is hosting the next regional conference of European Habitat. So I'm also on the preparatory committee for that event, and I will be talking here mainly about youth involvement in that event. However, I am not an expert on youth involvement or environment by profession. Nevertheless, I am very much involved in scouting. I know about scouting, so that is a lot about youth involvement, environment, and everything. So voluntarily, or with my interest, I'm involved with that a lot, not by profession. Yeah.
Thank you. Next, is Schindler.
My name is Ashish Schindler. I'm originally from Delhi. I'm based in Boston. I'm a student there. And I'm one of the organizing partner representatives of the UN Major Group for Children and Youth. That is an official General Assembly mandated space for young people to engage in UN processes, like the Sustainable Development Goals, like the disaster restructuring process, and in this context, Habitat 3. So we've been engaging in, officially engaging in the Habitat 3 process. This is Fairmont 1. And we are the chairs of the Children and Youth Constituent Group in the General Assembly of Partners, which is the official structure to engage civil society in the process. In addition to that, yeah, I mean, that's it, this introduction. And I'll be talking about a little bit on environmental issues, because that's a significant priority for us going through this process. And also what we did at the Asia Pacific Urban Youth Assembly. I'm sure some of you are probably attendees there, which is a few days ago, right before the Asia Pacific Urban Youth Forum, 300 local and national youth from the region that we gathered through a series of consultations, and there was an outcome, and so on.
Yes, thank you. But before we start our presentation, to give question and to make interactive discussion here, we know that you are still undergraduate student, perhaps, and we are still also undergraduate student, so we need more knowledge about the urban issues and so on, especially other issues. So this is okay. Deal.
Yeah.
The first presentation will be delivered by Aafis Kular, coming from UN Major Group for Children as Youth. Give me your first one. 10 minutes.
Hey, to come.
So just, I mean, I just continue on what I said. This is a platform one. It was the first meeting that took place in New York, but the Habitat process started in Fairmont 2 in Nairobi, and decided to do their own kinds of things. So, I mean, first things first, how can more young people officially at the regional and the international level? Through the UN process, all you need to do is you need to join the major group. It's very simple. You go on to the website, you click on join us, and you fill out a form. It's open to any individual age 30 and below, and it's open to any organization that is youth-led, that is the decision-making body controlled by people 30 and below, or any organization that serves young people and children. The only exclusionary aspect is that NGOs that are not youth-led cannot. That's how we generally work. In Habitat 3, actually, the person leading engagement in Habitat 3 is speaking at another side event, in the GAP side event, where you're not supposed to be there. So I encourage you all to join the mailing list, join the group, and you can start getting officially engaged. We have you joining us. That's basically how you get involved. I mean, we're already working with some partners in the region for the regional meeting. Happy to talk about that as well. So that's that. So what are a lot of young people saying in the context of climate and ecological issues in the region and globally? I mean, that is something I can address if you know that. So based on the official outcome of the Asia Pacific Union Assembly, the outcome slash statement and declaration, one of the cross-cutting themes that was identified while talking about the environment came under the heading of contextualizing urbanization in social and environmental externalities. Essentially, the text, the elaboration of it says that an urban space exists within a society that exists within an environment. So not only are social and environmental aspects components of the urban agenda, but the urban agenda is a subset of the environmental and social components. So this significantly changes the relationship between how we perceive the relationship between the process of urbanization and what we conceive of as the natural environment and the society. So what does this mean for the habitat 3 process in terms of what should the zero draft talk about, what should be the implementation mechanisms available to people on the ground? I mean, simply put, we say from a macro point of view that the urban environment and the process of urbanization should be reflective of and respect planetary thresholds, local biocapacity, and local scope of planetary boundaries. So a lot of things that happen during urbanization don't only have local impact, but have that global impact as well. So too much groundwater use, for example, in Jakarta, or using